Quick, du just remember Hamad Mur Sipir. Friedrich Red erzählt, she beshavas arz veish al tofu famed gimel, a shavas achrin al chayer, rabba magad, mizrish, bechayim, chayusu ba'al medin. Omar beshoch ve'al mitose. Tu gezogt azeh. V'mahamed ha chavrai kadisha. So you said a teiran vayishlach. Vayishlach yakeb malachim. And there's 2 days whether malachim means malachim. Angel says this, other means malachim means shluchim. It means literal malachim, not malachim, not we're using malachim for a term for shlichis, but it means literally malachim, in and of a malach. Only the mamish of the malachim, means the chilek hamamashus of the malachim, that was sent to Esav. Of the ruchni is not the mamish, the ruchni is nisharim Yaakov. At the Ramagid getayished, the vayishlach Yaakov. Tzarech lovim is it. So what's the reason why Yaakov had geshit malachim dafke? Even though this is Isser, v'lei b'nei Adam, mistabra lema shalufi shekanasa she Yaakov shalucha zu heis levar es heisev, because the kavon of the shalucha wasn't just to be medir him, it's a technical heidah, to find out where Esav is holding, and to be medir him, the Yaakov wants to meet him. If that was the kavon, the Esav should just notify him, the kavon handled sich, they didn't have to send malachim, and there's an Isser to stam use malachim stam as it. At the time, why did he send malachim? Because it was a job that only malachim could do. Why is it a job that only malachim could do? Because his kavanah was to make a tikkun in Esav. And b'chdei to be mesak in Esav, that's an onkum in some malachim. People could do technical things, human things, but in order to be mevarer Esav, to make a tikkun, a bitter ruchni in Esav, they need dafka malachim. V'lachin shalach ala malachim, ki dafka bekeicham lamalish lichazu. Pull us a bitter, dafka malachim have bekeich, to mevarer zan es edlin, Esav. Yeah, there's Marach in the artist, that's the Hechrech Lizeh, the Chocha, that the Shluchas Yaakov wasn't Stamazit to find out what the Matzev is, but to be Mevarer Esav. If the whole reason why he had to send Malachim was, in order to, because he needed, with the Shluchas, there's a certain Tikkun Ruchni, to be Mesak and Esav, to be Maile Esav from Klippis, whatever the Aved Avir it is. And Melini, people, human beings can do it. You need Dafka Malachim. What's the Maile of Malachim over human beings? I'm a Red Legabin of Bitter. The Maile is the Ruchnis of the Malachim. That the Malachim of Ashach is the Bitter. So then he'd have got to send the ruchnis of the malach, not the mamish of the malach. Lo mashalach ha'ilav racha mamish la malach. That he moved him to the pashish, he needed a bitter shaykh, because he killed the ruchnis of the malach. And if for the bitter you need to have the chilek ha'mashus of the malach, so there brings in the heart, the chilek ha'mashus is more shaykh by people, more the malach. Why did he say the malach? Because it was in the dafk malach can induf them, because it was in a bitter, in a tikkun ruchni. I'm not going to tikkun ruchni, so it's dafke shaykh to ruchnis of the malach. So if he clept is that he sent only the chilek ha'mashus of the malach. Das ist die Scheile. Es wird die Scheile fragt, gamm beätzen mir in eine Mugen. What's the pshat? Forget about, lommer sagen wat verstanden, that for the sake of bitter Esau, for some reason, the bitter has to be done dafke through the mamish aleich. Dafke through the mamish of Malachim. Ich habe asked before, that's kleptuch nicht. I'm red wegen bitter, so es dafke scheich der Ruchnis in Malachim. Lommer sagen wat den kentake mit Zayas in Azazach. Mit den kentake verstehen, that will explain somehow that the chilek habirur is neveh inside the mamish of malachim. But be'etzem in it, it's understanding, we can bechal tan azazach. How could you send the chilek hamamish that the chilek haruchni? Ich efshe lehavid bin hamamish lamalachim, which is the guf shalem, ruchni yusam haynu nafshim. Yeah, there means in the order that malachim also have a guf, but it's an edeler guf, some ruach ve'esh, a different type of guf. Rakabana, they also have an ukuda of mamish. But we can mafer zan between the guf and the nefesh. V'leimar shamamish alahem nishtach le'esav. V'ruchni is nishrei tziyakav. V'ikamen azazach ton. Kari afilu b'bnei odom balichayim adi minan nimna shaguf yase izu dover v'keich atzim yibli ha'nefesh shavay. It's kind of a teiter guf. V'netuch nish ha'teiter guf. But that the guf should function, do something v'keich atzim without the nefesh, that's kind of a the guf is basar v'atzamis. The guf is just chaymer. And adara is the chaymer of a malach, which the chaymer of a malach for sure, the guf is much more bottle to the nefesh. It's much more shaykh to the ruchnis of the malach. The guf is just a vehicle for the malach. It's not the mam. It's not a mitzias as the guf of Adam. The guf of Adam, the chaymer is much more of a mitzias. Mashiach in the guf of a malach is much more of an edeler guf. Why? Why is it edeler guf? Because it's more a whole mitzias of the guf over there is more a tuffle. Is more just a tuffle to the malach. So last time I come, we came and said that the guf of the malach should function on its own. It's clear to us that that's actually low. A tuffle of what the chomitz uses. But last time I come, she came and malachim she ikrim on nefeshim. So last time I come there, it doesn't make sense to say that the mamish of the malach, the guf of the malach, should be able to function on its own. Gamzarich lohavin. Okay, so that there are two kashas were on the etzim teira of the maggid. Now the Rebbe is saying that the kasha is where does the maggid base this teira off? Vanet nemter does that. What did Yaakov Avinu send? Only the chilek hamamashus of the malach. So the Rebbe has two shailas in the guf einyan and the teira of the maggid. Dik shaychah zogin first of all. the whole shlichus was dafke connected to the ruchnis of the malachim. Number two, how is it shaykh to send only malachim, the mamish of the malachim? The third shaila is where is the malach miyaseh this teira that Yaakov only sent the mamish of the malachim from Rashi? So Rashi is like punkt fakert. He's miyaseh this pirush on Rashi, and for Rashi come teis opposite to what the Maggid wants to bring out. Kansochon pashtus pirush Rashi malachim mamish. What does Rashi want to bring out to the word mamish? Nirish kavanasi lishla pirush shalosh luchem basaradam. Yes, that pirush that he sent malachim is only a term for people, for messengers, for shluchim. Then Zakhar Rashi, no, we mean over here literally malachim. Heinish Davis mamish harimad geshay malachim mamish. They were literally malachim. Don't think that it was people and because of a certain aspect of using the word malachim. We mean literally malachim. We mean tak malachim mamish. So b'teves mamish harimad geshay malachim mamish. V'leimitzi zacheres or meila b'chom muhosav inyanish shabchinas malach. The literally a malach. The full mitzias of a malach. V'ilu fi pirush hamagid shemuchum malachim mamish olishlos chilek haruchnis shebehem atzvam harad gosh Davis mamish olahipach. According to the Maggid's pshat, this punkt fakert. He only sent the mamash of the malach. The muhus malach is his nefesh, not his guf. His guf is just a tafel ba'alma. Much, much more than the tfeilos of the guf ha'adam. Even the guf ha'adam is tafel gabi his nefesh. The main thing is the person's his nefesh, his seichel, his midis, his chayis. The guf, that's not the chilek ikri, the chilek hamishah shavizah. By a malach, is much more that the ikri muhus malach is his nefesh. That's his inyan. So Rashi wants to say that we sent literally malach. That means don't make a toast and think that it was a psananda zach. Me main taka malach. Or Adam Kudum Agad Zach, me main tish malach. Me main zir mamish. So it's their mamish, it's not malachim altogether, because malachim is their nefesh. So it's the opposite of what Rashi is saying. So that doesn't make, that understand that the Maggid should say a pirush based on Rashi, heipach legami, what Rashi is trying to bring up. Yeah, it makes sense the words of Rashi, but it's against the whole mechuvan of what Rashi is trying to say. Kleptuch nizagna zazach. Oh, so mela pia kol anal tzaron nira leimar, she'en kamanazah shel Maggid amare anal, leimar she'akev shalach le'ezav rakis ha-mamish, va'guf shel ha-malachim le'badar. Nor geshikt v'chilik ha-guf, and the mamish of the malachim. Shu tofel kulei nechshet. That's b'chlal not, there's no significance b'chlal. It's not a metzias, the gabi ha-malach. B'liruch n'yusim v'napshom. Ve'al lefizah kum toiz de'al ha-kashas ad rebe frekt fir. That's a dover barur that the malachim, that Virashi zogt, malachim mamish. He literally sent malachim. He literally sent malachim. That means the nefesh of the malachim gegangen tzei iso. If was will the mamish, will the Maggid that is bringing that he sent only the mamish of the malach. Shkavanasi levayr, shashidu acham malachim hoi b'efim kazem. Shigam bebayim le'isa, b'yimotzim etzlei. Where is it? B'yimotzim etzlei b'gufim v'nafshom le'nitkum yiskashusim le'yakim. The Maggid will that is bringing before how he brings it out. What does he want to bring out? What he wants to bring out is that even though they left Takata Isa with the whole guf and their whole nefesh, but it didn't, there wasn't any nituk from Yaakov. But that a klal, which has negates that zveitin platz, so now they're Yaakov and Esav are two tzveva zundere. I mean, you have the tzaddik Yaakov and you have Esav, which is punkt fakir. So the malachim went to Esav. Did they lose a little bit from their kesher to Yaakov? Did they lose a little bit from being in Yaakov's from the ruchnis the way they were by Yaakov? Then zok the Maggid name. The malachim, the same dveikas and the same iskashas they had when they were by Yaakov. That iskashas and that dveikas to Yaakov, the way they were in his presence, wasn't nifkam legamri. They weren't in his presence, they went to Esav. Even though they went to Esav, they weren't in Yaakov's presence, they stayed as if they were by Yaakov's presence. That's what the market means. Gambe b'yam le'esav, v'imotzim, they were attacking in Esav's al-damis. But le'nitkum iskashus on Yaakov. Their kesher to Yaakov didn't become shvacher. They stayed with the same iskashus as if they were in Yaakov's presence. Ad, she'ki'ilu bo'y le'esav rak b'gufim mam shalem b'vat. As if they were still by Yaakov. As if Vasi gegangen to Esav, only technically, their chelik hagufni was by Esav. You have someone that's in a place, his guf is somewhere, but his nefesh is somewhere else. If his nefesh is somewhere else, and he doesn't pay any attention to the place that he's in, so the fact that he's in a different place is not going to make any reshem on him klal. If his nefesh and his meach stays mekusher to the original place that he was, so it's as if he's in the neichichus of the original place. So the same ashpa that the tzaddik has on him, the shas he was by the tzaddik is going to stay, even if he goes to a place that's distant from the tzaddik, because his nefesh, his meach, the lev is not pay attention to the new place that you're coming. You're here technically. Your guf is here. The flesh is there. Yeah, I mentioned gefinzach in a platz. Someone's in a dal damis and he doesn't hear bechal what the person is saying. It's just his buser b'dam is there. He's bechal now. His mind is somewhere else. So the things could be being said in a room. You could be sitting there, but if your mind is not there, it's not going to have any relation when you klal, because only your buser is there. So that's what the Maggid that is bringing. They came to Esav Taka. Their home, their nefesh and their guf is there. Usually, if you're nefesh and the guf go to a place, so you should be affected by the new place they are. Now you're in Esav's dal damis. You're far from Yaakov's Dadamas. You're in a different sviva. Avdem Zakter Maggid, they weren't Nivgam and Gamri Nish from from they had there was no nitik of their skashas to Yaakov, as if that their whole yachas, their what was by Esav, only their guf, only their chitzenis, and their nefesh wasn't the gamri there. It doesn't understand what's the pshat, but if they had to be mivare Esav, they had to be sensitive to Esav. So this is already nishtamazev sadat posh tezach, but he says like this. What's the pshahainu? Shayin, we can stack a sign that they went to Esav, and they went to Esav, you mivared him. If they mivared him, you can't mekenish trachten vegen Yaakov, and they had to be by Esav. That's the Rebbe's question to begin with. If they're going to come to Yaakov, and their whole mind is going to always be with the keich hatzir as if they're by Yaakov, and Yaakov's the Adam. So, they can't mivare than Esav. They have to be sensitive to Esav. But the Rebbe says, hainu. So, what's the pshat? They're only there with their mamish. They're only there as if only their physical, as if only their guf was there. Hainu, shayin nirgesh amashalei zeh omekem. Avad is angevendertin, but their hergish was that they don't belong there. They belong in Ishda. Their mohos vu belong in Zebayakiv. That was their hergish. Mekayim ha'amitihu etzal Yaakov. V'sham ikram v'nafshim. Vu is their mohos. Their mohos is darten. There brings in the order 9. Al derech. Teres ha'vashem makam shesheni shalom shalom anizim. It means avad, that's nish, that's a nish glat as a regular case where someone comes to a place, someone's sitting by in front of a gemara as a cup licking gans and ergets andush. He's dreaming. He's spacing out. He's b'chal avadah. So it's only his guf is on the gemara. His nefesh is b'chal not there. So that's verstehtman doch that it's only the mamish is there. Here, then you're not. Then you like have no contact b'chal with the thing that you're someone sitting in a class and heard b'chal nish b'smeret nish v'gan demnetza. Their nefesh was there and they had to be sensitive to Esav. But impossible b'shtana that they were only by Esav with their guf. So the standard of them, even though they were there, they thought about him, but they felt that the hergish was always that the fact that they're thinking about him, the fact that they're dealing with him, that's not their mahos. Their mahos is to be in Yaakov's Dal Damas. That's their mahos. That's where they belong. Like someone goes to a place and he's doing stuff, but he's sensitive a whole time that it's against his nature to do it. He feels uncomfortable doing it. He's somewhere, Lapel is doing it, and he's making cheshbeinus, he's thinking about it, but he feels the entire time that it's not this, it's hepech esteva to do it. That's what they're saying over here also. They felt that their mahos, they belong to be in Yaakov's Dal Adamas. Either being Mefarer Esav, their Indian is not being Mefarer Esav. That's not their Indian. Their Indian is not taking care of Esav. Their Indian is, even Beruchnis, even a Tikkun Ruchni. To do a bitter on Esav, that's not their Indian. Their Indian is to be in Yaakov's Dal Adamas. I lepel there by Esav, that's just technical. And it's Hepech Mahosam. And then Bashtan in the meaning. So it's as if Zeir Mahosam is gewendert. They're only the Guf and Mamish was there. Yeah, so this we're going to have to understand. What's the Pshat in them? Yeah, does I'm verstehen. L'chur, some is doing the Aveda of Birur, Birur of Esav. Why can't you say that Mretachnish, that your Mahos should be in Esav's Dal Adamas? Mretach, your Mahos should be in being Mesak in Esav. They were saying it's more than that. That's Avada, the Shluchas was in Mevar Esav. The Maggid was saying that even that the way to do Birur Esav is when you don't feel comfortable. Even being Mesakin Esav, you don't feel comfortable in Esav's Dal Adamas. Even being your Indian is not being Mesakin. Your Indian is Yaakov's Dal Adamas. Okay, we'll have to see this. Behem Shechasich. The Elam versteht was meret. Yeah. V'chol heyesam im kemish leitzav in elav chinas tafel bovad l'shem mili shluchus hashe Yaakov. This is only. It was only as if nish never steht zer. Zer Indian is to be by Yaakov. Yeah. Mekayim hamitu eitzav Yaakov v'sham ikar menashon. Their mahos is to be in Yaakov's Dal Adamas. Either by Esav, das ist Yaakov ist geschickt dahin. That's not their Indian. They were sent there. But dugma sagov shenim tzir la'atzmi al shtafel nefesh. So here the Rebbe is saying over here really two taichin. What's the pshat? He only sent the mamash of the malachim. The first in the beginning of this, a couple of lines earlier, the Rebbe says that the havana was even though they were by Esav, it's as if they weren't there. We want to say al derech, like I say, someone's in a chves in a shir and his nefesh is not there. Only his guf is there. So they were by Yaakov, they were by Esav. Their mahus wasn't by Esav. Yeah, that's the tachmal. Only the mamish was there. But the shas vi ken zayin azazach. They can't say that literally their nefesh was somewhere else and their guf was there. They had to deal with Esav. They had to be misasik with him. They had to think about him. So what's pshat? You can't say the literal musik of someone being in a place and his mind liktar gesandish in ganzen. So the Rebbe says the vart is that even though they take dealt with him, but there was always the hergesh given alamal that their Indian is not being mevar Esav. Their Indian is being Yaakov's Dal Adamas. Either doing this, that's only Yaakov is geshikt, so that's just the davar tofel. That's their Indian is Yaakov. Lepel Yaakov sent them to do kach v'kach, but that's not their mahos. And so the pshat mamish is al derech, like the guf is bottle. So they were there also benafshim lepel. They had to think about Esav. It's not only that the guf was there; they were thinking about it. They're being mevarim. But al derech, like the guf is a tofel of bottle al nefesh. Al derech zed, their being there was a tofel to their mahos. Their ikon mahos is by Yaakov. I you'll play here somewhere else. That's technical kavayachad here somewhere else. It's not a part of your Indian. You're there because Yaakov sent you there, not because your inyan is to be there. So it's aderech, like the guf's whole inyan. The inyan is not guf. The inyan is just a tafel anefesh. Aderech that they're being there. The inyan wasn't to be there. It was just a tafel because you're just being mamali Yaakov shluchas. Not that your inyan is to be mevarer Esav. Yeah. So the vart is, the shaila is when as imtzarat shluchas is the hergish is that this is my place. This is my job. This is my place. Or my place is by Yaakov. Pale, I was sent here, so I'm doing this. But my being here, that's not my mos.
That's your place.
No, your place is Yaakov. Your place is to be the Daladamas of Yaakov. Huh? No, your place is not to be Yaakov Shlokas. That's like the Rebbe Dov. Your place is to be by Yaakov. Yaakov, you're being Mamala Shlokas Yaakov. That's not, your mos is not the bitter, the Shlokas. That's the Rebbe saying here. If your mos becomes your job, the Shlokas that you have, and do you identify yourself with the shlichus, with the job that you have, with the bitter of Esav, take a shlicht. Then you can't be from all of the shlichus.
It's because of
Yaakov. It's not because of Yaakov. So your mahus is never that. Your mahus is to be in Yaakov's daladamas. And the fact that you're there, that's bederech tafel. My inyan is not to be here. My inyan is not there. My inyan is to be by Yaakov. Yaakov sent me here, so I'm here. It's not chazach. The fact that I'm here is a tafel. That attaches up. What does that mean? Where is their makam hamiti? Where is the mahus of this person? Where does he belong? Where is his true place? In Yaakov's daladamas. You're saying, what do you mean Yaakov's daladamas? His true inyan is to be a shliach. What do you mean? Not to be. Rabbi Zaknish does it. His true mahus is to be in Yaakov's daladamas. And the chol hayesim. Why? So why is he by Esav if it's not his place? Technically, he has to be there. Well, Yaakov atim geshikta insu. Not because that's his mahus. That's his inyan. Chenastafel means it's nisht in them b'shteit ver it is. Doesn't have any imprint on who he is. His mahus is Yaakov. Is being by Yaakov. And he was, his Yaakov sent him there. It's not chazal.
That's a good thing.
Huh?
Yaakov's place is a good thing.
Yaakov's place is an amazing thing.
Yaakov's shlichus is better.
The Rebbe saying over here, in order to be ma'ala the shlichus, you're chilek with the first thing. You could have your opinion, I'm not saying. We'll see in there, but the Rebbe's mevayim. The Rebbe got to give the chagan sabir. The Rebbe says not like that. You're learning a new thing now. I'm saying, look in the Ara 8. V'lechein harei ze pirish v'tevas v'yishlach Yaakov. Ki gam ze sharuch nis nishreim Yaakov reize chilek v'shachos m'shal Esav. The Rebbe says the pearl that the whole shlichas of Esav was to misakin Esav. The shlichas was to misakin Esav. If they would leave the ashpa being in Yaakov's daladamas, and there would be any yachas to Esav, they wouldn't be able to be mevarer. The only way to be mevarer them was if they stay with the full hafshata of being in Yaakov's daladamas. Only if their mahus stays in Yaakov's daladamas, they are going to be able to be mevarer Esav. That's again the shlichus. What in vasfara if in firtzach adurch deva yishlach Yaakov? If they ligenisht, if there's no yachas and sima slave to the makam amikabel. The fact that I'm here is I'm fulfilling a mission here because Yaakov sent me to do it. There's nothing. I have nothing to do with this place. What are you doing here? I was sent on a mission. Nothing to do with because my mahus is shayich here. Yaakov sent me to fulfill a certain mission, but my mahus has no connection to this place. My mahus is in Yaakov's daladamas. That's the... Yeah, there's going to be a yirah later, the Gavish Lichas Mamish, but it does have a pashtein taka, what's the...
It's not pshat, the nefesh of the shlichas is Yaakov. It's not the pshat.
No, we'll see. There's a whole something. There's the ganze sikha. We'll see how the Rebbe is going to back. Yeah, but if you want, if you don't have patience, if you look, where's the Rebbe say at the end? Yeah, the Rebbe Rettach at the end. Okay, the Rebbe Deira is okay. Mit Balzer, the ganze Meister, we'll see. Pisa Yuvon, Asher Lei, Zubalat Shepirah Shamag, Dosh Estevas Mamish, Eni Seish Lepirah Shapash Shabbat Gosh Estevas Zu, Ela Ad Rebbe Mavari Mavirah. It was like Rashi. Rashi zogt that who did he send? He literally sent Malachim. He literally sent Malachim. What's a Malach? A Malach is Eidus Amar Kovet Alakus. Eiser Alakus Veser Garnish. That's Malachim Mamish. Literally Malachim. What's the Mahos of a Malach? Zagantz was Alakus. He had to pay attention to Esav, so he had to become aware of Metzias of Klippa, of Yesh, of Rasha. So he wasn't literally a Malach. Was he in the state of literally a Malach? See, this person, he was literally a malach. Literally, Kolin Yoni is Abbas Hashem. Kolin Yoni is Dveikus Talukus, Bittel Talukus Betachlus. Lepoil, when he was sent to Esav, he wasn't literally a malach, because he had to pay attention to that. He had to speak Esav's language, he had to deal with Esav. How does Rashi say, literally malach, Lechori was in a tunu of dealing with Esav? So, of them, they're magid mefarish, but Rashi zot. אלא אדרבה, הוא מבאר, כי האפשר שיש מלאכים ממש, לפלביר ועשב, תחס לגעש את החומרס, הוא דווקא כשנפשם ורחון יוסם דפוקו קשורה ביעקב, ואין המשתנס גם כשנמצא מצל עשב. יא, בוא זה תקד הרביר, עד מכן תקד, first of all, that you should be able to maintain the union of מלאכים ממש, and that you should be able to מבאר את תקד עשב, which is תחס לגעש את החומרס. It's not so posh. Tachlis hagashmis v'chumris. Mivar eisav is just take if a yeshus, take if a klipa. Tachlis hagashmis v'chumris. Yeah, the epitome of hagashmis v'chumris. To take care of such a cheshach as dafke, if you're tachlis haruchnis. Tachlis haruchnis means there is no yirida klal in your ruchnis. To take care of a psa cleaner geshem, nishta zagreser geshem, so maybe you don't need to have such a tachlis haruchnis. But if it's tachlis hageshem, you need tachlis haruchnis. Tachlis haruchnis means that there is no nesina smakim klal to a tnu of hepech halukus. What does it mean Yaakov? Yaakov's Aladamus means there's no veld. There's no mitzias outside of the Eibishter himself. That's tachlis aruchnis. There's no nesina smugna from mitzias of yesh. If you're going to pay attention to Esav means that you're becoming aware of the fact that there's a yesh, you have to be understanding when you speak to Esav, you're relating to him. That's not tachlis aruchnis v'afshat. Tachlis aruchnis v'abitl. In order to take care of tachlis agashmis, you have to be connected to tachlis aruchnis v'anashamah. So we can take a the malachim going to Esav, being in Esav's Aladamas, how are they not affected at all by Esav? They had to think about it, they had to deal with him. The Teretz is, they weren't there. They felt that the Havnish Kishachism at their plats. They were dealing with him, they were talking to him, but it was as if Esav ret yesh, zom gehert v'saret, but had no, it didn't make sense to them, achal v'olim. Sinir zeirzah. They're in his yakah, they're in his tachas abitl. So what are you doing there if you're in tachas abitl? Yakah v'tmer geshik, tzenachazah. I was sent by Yaakov to do it, but that's not where my mehus is. My mehus is not giving a tzitzis mokim to mitzitz and not speaking a language that Esav understands. That's not my language. Even when I'm speaking it, it's not my language. So why are you speaking that language? That's technical. That's tough. I was sent there by Yaakov. That's what the Rebbe said. V'nimtza eifu is a pirusha shel ha-magid. Sh'rak ha-mamesh sholach Yaakov le-Esav madgish eid yeses pirusha ha-shposha shol tevas mamesh. Sh'sholach esam alochim even shohyu v'nishiru malochim mamesh. So those I'm fashtein, we have to understand, first of all, what's the pshat in them? What's the pshat? That in order to malachim tachas, in order to mevarim, the Rebbe says this, the Rebbe says that in order to mevarim the Esav, you have to be tachlis aruchnis. That's what the Rebbe says. Good. But the shaila is, if you're tachlis aruchnis, how is that going to affect Esav? If you're, there's no kir of the Esav's mos, how are you going to affect him? How is shaychas a zayin? How is it shaychas that a yid should be in a state where he's by Esav and Afa Bekein, he stays with Tachas Haruchnis, Tachas Apshat, as if, and his makim, his mohos is not Mishtan Alagam. Rebbe got this gemmits vashti. The Elam is betech Einin, mehert, what's the Retzach? Yeah. Sam, you're saying about the Shluchis, but why do you have Anocha okay, I don't know what you mean. This is a besonder shmus. Okay.
The other didn't answer that question by saying that it's mekayme, meaning your answer.
The other says mekayme hamiti yotze Yaakov. What does that mean? Saying with pasha sedvar.
With all sensitivity, like you said, at the same time.
But you're. It doesn't suit you that you're here.
So why did that oppose the shluchim?
It's like when opinion when American shlichus he put on a tie. He didn't feel comfortable in the tie. It didn't suit him. He wore it. Okay, but that's it. Yeah, he wore it. He didn't identify himself with it. I'm not saying that a tie is a hebrew mitzvah. The Rebbe is saying the necessity is that you don't. Of course, you relate to your makom shlichus. But the Rebbe is saying in mohusa inyan, your place is elukus bepshitus, not elam hazeh. You have to be in elam hazeh lepoel. Your nevish and your guf. Your nevish also has to be in elam hazeh. But it's not your mohus. Your mohus and your ratzin is to be in Yaakov's daldams. Yeah. Fred Rashaila, I'm saying, okay, today it's hard to, but someone goes on shlichus and he doesn't want to come back to go to be in the Rebbe's daldams. The Rebbe in case of our shlichus is only on shlichus and that's it. That's you understand is not. So why the shluchim come to the Rebbe? I'm saying, well, Stan was yesh, their mitzvahs, legarmi, it's for themselves.
Because
they had to have what to say.
No.
Why did they have to go?
The
Rebbe is saying, punkt vaker to be, it's nishtas. Okay, let me say, Mr. Mazbi, Rebbe Vair. Yeah. Okay, we'll see how the Rebbe is invited. Amar esh lamaged hanal, v'chin eira me'anal b'avidaseinu, v'tun beser v'ashtein, yuvim b'teis v'zbir, adeh ha'izbeninus b'azman v'amatze d'amir es teiru zu. Let's go rein trachten, the zman when this teiru was said, and the matze v'u has sich gehalten. Kinnitzke leir teiru zu omra amaged b'shabes archin esh lofnei es lakusse. And the Rebbe says also that he was b'shach v'al erish, no, he was that he was b'shach v'al mitase. Is this not so? B'shach v'... where is it? B'shach v'... that brings in the Pnim? B'shach v'al mitase. B'shach v'al mitase. Yeah, yeah, b'shach v'al mitase. Yeah. So the Rebbe says that, so that's, so, shemizem muvan shememaymer zu, yesh kein savo v'yiro ha'klolis ha'vayez ha'sham ha'pidar ha'chesed. This is not stam edover prati. This is a'yiro ha'klolis ha'vayez ha'sham ha'pidar ha'chesed u'lemeshach ha'der ha'sabayim. Yeah. As a kein tzava, this is the tzava. We don't call it Hashem. Apidar chassidus al nemeshach aderes abayim. Mikivan shem beit hamidav shel Rava Magid. Haya admar azagin a talmid achav v'lo b'yeisa. Kneida shel Rava Magid lo madim admar azagin v'efim miyuchad u'b'teisav v'siseira limudim shara talmidim. That's number one. Again, the talmid achav v'lo. Who already you see that he learned out Rebbe in a special way and b'teisav with a yisaf. Then they got be other talmidim. And then he adds, that even what he learned where the Alter Rebbe was there with everyone, besides, the Magid gave a special, it was unique attention to the Alter Rebbe. That's the Einza. Then even when the Alter Rebbe was the Maimed Kulam, the Chdua, the Maimed from the Balditchever, Kulam, and Me'al Gegesen from Ein Shisel, and the Litvak, the Kavanah to the Alter Rebbe, Kikin Hayniki Rafi Tamid, Rav Magid, Lok Achele Kamufcher. So even Vasar Gehatmet Alman, he took the smetin of the Indian. So Hari Muvan, Shairo Anal. Since the Talmud Achi Chaviv is the Alter Rebbe, so who is his Savo Mechuvan to? Who's going to carry out the Maggid's mission in the Eifin Achi Mufchar? That's going to be the Alter Rebbe. So that Heira of the Maggid, there's a Savo for in order, Savo Heisar, get the Chavek from the revolt. What's the message that he's leaving, what we should continue with? Lachir Stakusi. So who's the one that's continuing game in the Hechsleif, and that's the Alter Rebbe? Said Mu'an Sheira Anal Shal Adar Rav Magid Shal Amr Samuch Lis Takusim Mechuvenes the Seder Avedish La Admar Azogin Si Semeres Shal Chassidus Chabad. Vapi Mamori Yiduah Shal Rav Magid Shal Amr La Admar Azogin Yitzkislev Hu Yomtev Yem Ayilula Shalom. So Unzer Yem Ayilula Yitzkislev Mizgal Salik Rav Magid Yisay Yem Mishnah Stav Kvidah Yisay Admar Azogin Lachirus Masar Rav Uzash Gila Teres Chassidus. Mistaber lema shatera anal heyes ba amra magad lifnei yema iluda shalei. Yesh a shaykh is mechadis yema iluda shal admar azagin. Hainu liyem kula zat admar azagin. Means, since everything, every prat is negeya and every prat is meduik. Every prat. So the fact they said it's samuch listal kusay is it's a tzava. If it's a tzava, it means that it's a yirah lemeshach deiris habayim. It wasn't stam. Something the magad said b'chaye, it's not a message for the generations after. It's not a tzava. Hashem, if he said samach listakusi, it's b'teras tzava. B'teras tzava means that it's for a yirah, for deiris lachir, it's number one. And it's a dover klali. That's a tzava. You don't give every detail on a tzava. Tzava is your main essential points you give out on a tzava. And for the deiris habayim, that's number one. Number two, the fact that the Pel Mamash was close to Yitzhak Kislev. So, mitvelche inni das verbunden with the inni of Yitzhak Kislev. Besides the fact that it was samach listakusi. So it's a tzava, but the fact that it was close to Yitzhak Kislev, because the stakus could have been any other day, but it's Yitzhak Kislev. So the mashmos is that it has to do with the inni of Yitzhak Kislev. What's the inni of Yitzhak Kislev? If in prati, the inni of Afatzam Yonas Chutz. I mean, there's common yon in Chassidus Chabad, in Andre Verte. But Dor Retman Ayirah Klolis, in the inni of Chassidus, which the way it's connected to the inni of Yitzhak Kislev. There's Chassidus Chabad, the way it's connected to Yitzhak Kislev. That's going to be Mivai. This year, it's also like this, yeah? We can learn another 14. That's when they get attacked this year. Befrat kshakvi yisi shechol yitas kisli bepashas vayishlach. So take a shgoha pratis. Shoz neisif al anal yesh na hirat admar azakin sirichum lichis mazman hainu pashas shavua zi semerish pashas shavua sirichum lakach zi hirat bir al inyara manasim shavua zi. Meilu, this yitas kisli, this has to be the focus. This year yitas kisli, the focus is the maggots teira on the pashas vayishlach. Okay. Fine. Dal, yim gula zi yitas kisli. What's the chiddush of the Yiteskis? The chiddush of Behu? The inner of Yefutso Ma'inesecha Chutza. Which the Rebbe is going to explain the Hemshech HaSicha, what's the inner of Yefutso Ma'inesecha Chutza. So, Im She'ini Yefutso Ma'inesecha Chutza Muvani Kipshutai, Hafatzas Ma'yonash HaTeres HaChsidis, to spread the Ma'yonash HaChsidis, Teres HaChsidis. Omno, Mekim, and Shisrael Meskashiram Be'ir Aysa. Not only the Merkusher Beteira, but Yidin Ateira are one Mitzias, one Kuda, Kulachad. Haribuvan, Shkasha Nasa Chidish of Chinas Ateira, Shasavert, Inin Fana Fatze. In Teira, Chidish in Teira, Nasa Chidish, Dugmasi, Beisir Shah, Gamim Chinas Yisrael. So the same way in Teira, Tchuv Gitan, the Inin Fana Futsa, Mana Secha Chutsa, there's a negated Mohosa Vayid, which Yid is Yisrael, Veirasa Kulachad, also the Tuvgat and Azam Shart Inin of Yefutsu, Mayonas of Vayid Chutsa. Which that's going to be the main arichis of the sikh. The chiddush of fatzim yonis chutzah legabi ayid v'nishmasi. Mayonis ilav shiutas kislev huschala fatzasi chutzah is the mayonis of primis atel. Nigle day raisa dasi gaven ba fatzah echefar yitas kislev. The ufto of the fatzim yonis chutzah of yitas kislev is the fatzah of primis atel, which primis atel is called nishmasi day raisa. Why taka was nishmas atayre behelim and gufe deraisa begili? The Rebbe is saying that's not only as if you mitzad bepashat al pidin. There's halachas. Talking about ma'aser merkava. Since we're dealing with delicate inyanim, we're talking about yedias elokus. So there's hagbolas of how you're supposed to teach it, who you're supposed to teach it, and what type of setting. But the Rebbe is saying here, the fact that it was behelim is inside the etzim nature of primis atayre. Primis atayre is that etzim uhusay is an eifen of hell, not just mitzad sibis dodi is mitzad hagbolas of like you have in Shechon Aruch, mitzad people, delicate things, learning it nishvi is after them. The Rebbe says there's a different word. Dugma lahefer shahayis shibayin guf ha'adam v'nishmas. Haguf hi mitziyiz gluye v'nikaris. Yeah, the guf is a apparent and a concrete, tangible mitzias, a galiyadik mitzias. She'ef shaler eisa olam ashesha. So it's a mitzias gluya. Mashikin ha nesham shalei zubavad. She'ef shaler teifsa b'hiya achud. Mered, the nesham is not a mitzias gluya v'nikaris. Shalei zubavad, she'ef shaler teifsa b'hiya achud shma gufni. Kenesh on tap in the nesham. Kenesh nishmekin. Can't see it. Elish she'ef shaler hasiko gam b'keach ha-seichel ha-dak. Even with a keach ha-seichel dak, an edel ha-seichel, ha-seichel mufshit, there is no, you can't have and can't fissinist what the nefesh is. Can wissen that there is an neshama, there is chayis, there is an neshama. At the pool as an neshama baguf. The zesha guf chayim, if chayiv, and maybe liyadiyas tzichlis, she baguf nimtzas, nefesh chayim chayis. Avom husa shala nefesh, she lamadim asaga tzichlis. That I was saying, the neshama, the nefesh, is in of chayis, it's not in of chayis, it's something which has no tzir. We have no hasaga what chayis is, what nefesh is. We know that there is a dover chayis. We know that there is a from the fact that the guf is alive, the guf is moving and it's thinking and it's doing and it's walking. We know that there's a source, a nefesh, there's a life force that gives life to the guf. But what exactly is this life force? We have no idea what the life force is. It's not nitvas nasaga, it's hechaf nasaga sutlas. So it's an efen of helim. There's no kalim for it. There's no way of being tapis. It's in the pshitis. It's hecher from mitzias. It's not a mitzias gluya. So v'achidish it is kislev shema oz ve'elach. Gam chilek ha'nelem v'apnimi de teira. So alderz legabi gufa nisham nishmas adam. Alderz legabi gufa deiraisa v'nishmasa deiraisa. That the gufa deiraisa is the chilek ha'teira which is mugdur and mitzoyer. It's a mitzias gluya v'nikeres. Ze osur v'ze mutter. It's a seichel dvarim mukshim. It's a seichel mukshim. Seichel anushim. Dvarim mukshim. Mashikin the inyanim of primis atayra are dvarim mufshatim. In pshitis. Primis alukus. No tzir. No agdar. V'chidish it is kislev shema oz ve'ela gam chilek hanelem v'apnimi detayra nim shechabol edigili. Also those inyanim pnimim that is gali gavon. Ad shenitan lelamde u la'asige b'seichel k'me shema sigim is chilek hanigli detayra. Afil lafitzi chutzah. These became open inyanim which a person could relate to them, could understand them. And grasp them in a full grasp. Punkt as a person is able to understand the svar and nigelik and fashtin. In the inyanim of chassidus, when it's slabish in asage and musagim and ideas that you can understand, and they become ideas that are relatable to the chutz. You're able to they become messages. They become ideas. They're able to publicize. It means they became open, accessible ideas, apparent ideas. They're not dvarim stumim v'ne'alamim. The bederek klal. You want to give over a sadaver sasim v'ne'alam. In a pshitis, the person has to be a psakeli to be margishit. But if you're in a chutzah, you can't give them over in a way that someone that is not in tune to pesaimik should have a saga. They're ever saying that matmabish given a lukus in azal chayifanim in a lufushim of a saga. Even someone that's in chutzah means he's not in tune to grace a pshitis nafshat. He's a regular seichel or chutzah. Also there, you're able to be mefarshim than yonim that rayonis of chassidus. That's the chiddush in Torah. In the chiddush zeshe b'Torah, gili nishmasi deiraisa. B'dugmasi v'ayodei punkt azevi in Torah given der chiddush since Yisrael v'kashiram b'eiraisa. And Yisrael v'kuchibichu, Yisrael v'Torah eschad. So b'dugmasi nischadish oz gam v'chines Yisrael. der selber Uftu ist ein Schadisch geworden, also bin ich gehe Tayyid. Because Yisrael will ihr Reise hat. Der Rebbe ist in Ordnung 19, befreit Bria so Adam, lo amal Teri Yulat. Wir mehr den Moment, schnaß ein Chidisch bei Teri, nass ein Eise ein Chidisch gamm bei Adam. Was ist der befreit? In der Yisrael, because Yisrael hat, ist in der Primi, auf Primi ist der Teri, auf Zayar. Der Rebbe ist ab die Pashtus. Die Gemara says, that Adam lo amal Yulat, a person was created for the sake of harving in Teri. So Teri and a person, even a penigla is one thing. A person's chitzeni says, "Stop going into primis Yisrael because Shabbichu Chad Yisrael is kasham beiras." It's in Goli. A person was created for the sake of harving in Teri. So his home, so his mitzvahs lachatchila connected to Teri. He suited to Teri. So m'shas v'tachidish in Teri, v'tachidish bayim. Okay. Shanashama shabeish misadatzmi. So what's the chuvik atan? Shanashama shabeish misadatzmi. M'chinasi behelam kanal. Teri es lebigile haynu gam b'nyana aguf shalei. The neshama zal meir zayn in guf in inyan aguf. So that's what I was going to be masbir here. Was handelt sich? Das geht dir gerne zu verstehen. Let me zayn verstehen. It says bir adover. Yeah. So we're not saying was the neshama is in apshitis, but the neshama should be nirgash begilui in the inyan aguf. That I was going to explain what that means in sifay. As Eptan zagen as sifay is the schol of the inyan. And then the, where he speaks the Nekudah of Chassidus Be'ikr is in Sif Zayin. But there's a, this is like a line from the Inyan, the Rebbe starts off from Sif Hei. Bira Dabar. This is really Agdam in a way to what the Rebbe is going to say Behemshech. Be'ez Galutah Shal HaNasham Be'guf. I'm read that the Nasham is Nirgash and Meir in the Guf. It's from Be'ez Efanim Klolim. There's two Efanim, Vifal the Nasham Herzach in Guf, and how the Guf is affected by this Gilu. Yeah, the Rebbe says number one is that it's Galas HaNasham Be'midah Kazu. In what for the Eifin is the Neshama Meir in Guf? In the Eifin that she has the Shlita the Guf. But Guf Nichna lo. But because the Nirgash Guf, can you see this last one? Yeah, there's one Eifin. The Guf doesn't only mean Pashit Guf. The Guf means the whole Marechas of the Guf. The Guf, the Nefesh HaYunis. There's one Tfis of Chaim. Chaim Gufnim. There's a Guf. A person is a Metzias. And he has a whole life. His Gufnim is the life. Yeah, he's hungry, he gets hungry, he gets tired, everything is basically surrounded around him. Then there's Neshama. The Neshama is Chilk Kami Mal Mamish. The whole Nekudah of the Neshama is to Behem is Meir Lekus Begili. So there's one, even the Neshama Bechal is not Meir of the Guf. Yeah, you have a Guf and you're Bechal not sensitive that there's something deeper to that has surrounded Ebeshter. Your whole life is surrounded around your own Metzias. And in your guf, in your conscious mitzvahs, in your guf, in your regular life, you bechal not margish is found in the neshama. Then your guf is the dominant chelik. The nachi found that the neshama is begili in the guf. That means that a person is margish. It's meir benafshe that there's a neshama. It's a neshama. So he's margish the emes of a lukus. He's margish that a lukus is adasi the emes. So the one eifin is that he's margish lukus is the emes. So lepoil mamish, his guf is a mitzvahs. And his guf has tzeinus, and his guf has his function, his way of life. The poel he bothered his margish at the neshama does the emes. So what is that poel? Because the guf heard as frana emes, so he's nichna to the neshama. The guf is the even though my mitzias and my interest would be kach v'kach, but if your margish is a emes, it's a hecher from here. You're in his battle klapi that emes. That's one eifin. If the emes is not mir altogether, then your whole life surrounds just around yourself. Even if the emes of your neshama is mir, so mir has to get like that. So there's an evish there. What is that pill when you're margish at this emes? The first, the basic shlav in your margish far emes, where your margish is a mele. So I have to machne myself. It's not my geshmak. It's not my interest necessarily. But that's the emes. And if the emes is mir, you're sensitive to the emes. It's going to be mechayev that you should be nizbatal to the emes. And the emes should be the one controlling and be the dominant power in my life. That's the first leaf. But I will because Nirgash Guf Kimtzias Latzim. But the Guf is still a Mitzias. The Guf has his own Ritzenis. He has his own Cheshik, his own Inyanim. What's the Inyan? Zweiter Eifin Faran Shanisham. So the Zweiter Eifin Faran Shanisham Ibizgal is called Kach Ba Guf Ash Guf Inyan Mitzias Latzim Klal. And meet this Inyan Gilan Neshama Guf. Another Eifin is that the Neshama is, as I was saying, is fully begili in the Guf. That means Amit is Inyan Gilan Neshama Guf. The neshama is in the guf to the fullest extent possible. The most, the ultimate that the guf is able to handle. What's the ultimate? The ultimate is that this nizgal in the guf, that the guf is margish, that its whole mahus is just being a levush to them, just being a keli to them. Yeah, shama is gal guf kol kabah guf asher guf enim tzis la'atz miklal. Yeah, guf is not mitzvahs for himself. What's the whole inyan guf? The whole inyan guf is a durchfir, and the emes is what's nirgash in the neshama. Nirgash neshama is that so the other ebeshar and besides the ebeshar, nothing else exists. Hulavadi uvein zolasa. Besides the emes is mere betachlis. So it's mere tachlis is that the guf also magish that the einzige zach is the holocaust. And what it's all metzias is to be a levush to durchfir into the sinus and the kavanas of the neshama. That's its whole metzias. Yeah. But there's no chesed from this. I was going to touch up. But dugma leguf and nefesh of nafshi b'hamis v'chiyunus. Had the ef shel chali b'nei v'lema shaguf metzias la'atzmi v'chiyuaser the sinus l'nefesh akad esibushli. Yeah, we can't actually say that the guf is a metzias for itself, which functions on its own. Yeah, it's a guf. It's a whole metzias, and it has kavi yochel its retzenis and its mahus, its kav, its mahalach hamachshav. And then, the nefesh is stronger than the guf. The nefesh is ruchni, the nefesh is nefesh. So the guf is only basar v'dam. So since the guf is only basar v'dam, so the nefesh is chayis. The nefesh is much more of eichus dikem metzias than the guf. So now the guf is machniyeh itself. The nefesh vil the guf, since the guf is tak metzias shel basar, which is shalei be'erach be'eichus lower than the nefesh, it's machniyeh itself to the nefesh. Ken the chazan nish tazei the pshat. That's the chayis of the guf. The whole chayis of the guf is the nefesh. Well, the whole mahus haguf is the fact that this is the chayis shubit. The mitzvah, the guf is not a mitzvah for himself. It's not a function for himself. His whole mahus is that his whole mahus is the nefesh. Saying that's a chayis is the nefesh. And his whole Indian is that the nefesh should be pearl through him. That's the whole mahus. The whole mahus, a person is happy, a person smiles. It's not that the nefesh is happy and then you're mitzaveh the guf to smile. The whole mitzias aguf is to reflect the nefesh. That's the whole mitzias aguf. The nefesh, adas is ein chayis, adas is ein mahus. That's his chayis. It's not something else. What's the guf? The guf is just the levush, the chayis. It's just a mirror of what's going on in the nefesh. That's the whole mitzias aguf. So if the guf is just a mirror of what's going on in the nefesh, but shaster nefesh is a fridden, you don't have to be proud that the guf should be happy. If the nefesh is happy, then the guf is happy. The guf's whole Indian is to reflect the nefesh. That's chatchil his whole mahus. He's just a reflection of something else. He's not a mahus for himself. Since the nefesh is the chayis aguf, sarei miyuchad ma nefesh. The guf is erish tezach, ein zach with nefesh. That's his chayis. And he's bottled to the nefesh. That means that the guf's whole Indian is to reflect the nefesh, not something else. So there is a derech zez b'negiel l'chayis neshama b'nei Yisrael. A derech like I say b'negiel t'nefesh v'guf. So a derech zez b'negiel l'chayis neshama b'nei Yisrael. That amitis ha'inyan is that the neshama is the chayis and the pnimius of the guf. It's not something else. The guf is just a levush to reflect the neshama. That's the whole guf sinyan. A derech zez b'negiel t'nefesh v'nei Yisrael. A derech b'negiel l'chayis neshama b'nei Yisrael. Atum kureim od ma'ashamad am le'ali. Shigam chayus magash misim nefesh olikis. Ayid is adam le'elyin. So that means that the pasuk says atam kriim adam. It's ungrufen. I mentioned, but the shalos says that adam is not Hashem offering an adam. Adam is Hashem adam le'elyin. That means that the adam atam get a chafa mensh dolamata and yidin lamata in this world. And yidin are called atam kriim adam Hashem adam le'elyin. That means that yid lamata. Chayus agashmis is adam le'elyin. Chayus agashmis is from the nefesh olikis. She called in Yoni Mitsuyusi the Gufa Israeli who Shahu Klila Nisham. The Ganse Indian Mitsuyus in the Guf is, he's not a Mahus for himself. He has no Mahus for himself. What's his whole Indian? What's his whole Mahus? To be a Kaili at the Nisham is a kind of Durkhfir and Zainizah. Chdesha Nisham to Khalakam and Sinish Lakadish Baruch. Hamalubish, when it says Maisi is, the Nisham's Indian is Zain Batal Selikus. He's a Chalaka Kalim Al Mamish. And his Indian is that the Abish's Kavana should be in the Smalit. That's the Nisham's Indian. Bechdea the Nisham is a kind of Isfir and Mabish's Rasin. Which some of them are connected to in Yonim Gashmi, Tfilin Sitzes Dakahulu, is Dafka Ide Ivar of Hagashmim Shlaguf. Hashim Suzi Shlaguf, who the Tachlezu, Shabay Valyadi Pelas and Jom Mashlimas Tafkid Vailam Hazar. So what's the Shlemas? The Shlemas is that the Guf feels that what's his Mahus? His Indian is Milui in Yoni of the Neshama. That's his Indian.
The first item is not practical.
Huh? What do you mean practical?
It doesn't happen.
What do you mean doesn't happen? That's the Beirani of your Pashtas. The regular Beirani is Meir Shalit Alalev. This is, I mean, the second Eifin is someone is all halting thereby that it's that a same way is guf. The whole matzias a guf is to be a emtsoy for the nefesh, to reflect the nefesh. The guf is one with the nefesh. Al derech ze the guf vayit his whole matzias is that is just in order for the ratzon elyon to be nisman, in order for the neshama to durch for in zayin inyan. That's a ganz a fine dargi.
That doesn't happen automatically. It sounds like it's pshutos. That's what it is
by a regular person. By every yid, that's the emes. That emes is it. That's the guf of a yid. B'meila, since that's the emes, we could a person through aveda. If the reality was that the Ebesha created a guf, that in yoni is guf, then for night was Morgan. I mean, the Alter says the emes is that Adam Kurim Adam. The emes is that what's the truth? Apitera. What's the mitzvah Mitzvah Aguf? The Mitzvah Aguf is Kolin Yana is that the Ratzon of the Neshama should be Nesmal. That's the whole Mitzvah Aguf. The Ratzon of the Neshama is Kim Ratzon Aber. In order for the Ratzon Aber to be Nesmal, you have to have Yivarim Gashmi. Since that's the truth, a Yitra Veda could be Megale and can take a Ufton that should be take his Guf. That should be literally his reality. By that's a tzaddik. A tzaddik Zayid, which is Mefatel Nefesh Bahamis. So there's a Nishyaz and Nisham, and the Nisham is Machai is Guf. It means his Guf is Makabal Chayes of his Nisham. How is the Guf Makabal Chayes of the Nisham? Because the Guf is in Yoni, is flesh and blood, and the Nisham is Achilah Kamim Mamish. The Teret says Achilah Kamim Mamish, the Yoni of the Guf is, Tachlisa is that the Nisham is in it, should be Nismal. That's the Mitzvah Guf. It doesn't have any, there's nothing else to itself. Okay, we don't have to go through every single Prat. After Durgin, we don't have to go through every single Prat. We'll start Zivov. Beis Madreges Anal, we'll do these two Madreges and then we'll... I just want to be madgish one thing. Okay, the Rebbe's going to say touch up later. We'll see later. Beis Madreges Anal, Be'efim Gidei Anashame. One Efim Anashame, Rak Sheleta Salaguf. Yeah, B'shas Zmer Asfarna Emes. What's the first response? Asfarna Emes. That's my mohos. Meichetes, that's my mohos. My mohos is I have an Efshach Yunus. My mohos is eating, drinking, taking care of myself. There's a manach hazachai. There's a guf. The Eibusha created the world that the guf has a whole system of life and he has his interests and things. But she said, they heard their emes. So they heard their emes. Verter eis mitzias. They heard verter eis mitzias. But as they heard their emes, so the emes is going to be the one in control. Not the emes is much stronger than stam as a life force of eating and drinking. That's what I like doing. That's my mitzias. But she says, the emes is mayor. It's mechayev me to be in his battle. That's the first Eifin. Then that's not the ultimate Gila Emes. The ultimate is Mitzada Emes, there's no other Mitzis. The truth is in Mitzada Neshama there is no other Mitzis. There's only the Eivishta. So if the Emes is mayor in a way that there is a Mitzis, Elamayam battle to the Emes, then the Emes is not fully mayor in the Guf. Because the Guf at the end of the day feels that it has a Mahus Bifnei Asmi. So Hakol, the Emes is greater than me, and I have to be Mizbatal to the Emes. But what's the vi is their Emes? Their Emes is as Nishtakin Guf. That the only thing that exists is the Eivishta himself. And the whole Metzias Aguf is just a tuffle to Elikus. So when the Nesham is Meir Begila Yeser, when the Emes is Meir with its full, when the full Emes is Meir, then what's the Hergesh Aguf? That his whole Metzias is Hechetimsa, that the Ratzin Elin should be Nesmal, that the Ratzin Nesham should be Nesmal. So that was in Taichus later. That's Tali, these two Efanim, if the Guf is a Metzias Bifnei Asmi or not, that's Tali, how much the Emes is Meir. If the Emes is Meir, how much the Guf is able to handle, so the Guf stays in Mitzvahs for Zich, and the Emes is only Pale on it, it doesn't take him out of his Mitzvahs. The Emes is just Pale, that the initial Hergish of the Emes is, I'm left this battle against the Emes. You have to do it, you have to be Machnir yourself to the Emes. But when the Emes is Meir with its fullest passion, with its full glory, so Vazag the Emes, as Esel Kosi Garnish Ishta. And if that's Meir in the Guf, what does the Guf become? As that there's no such a thing Guf. There's no Indian of Guf. The whole Indian is that the Likus should be, the Ratzon Elyon should be in the Smal. That's the whole Metzius HaGuf. Beis Madreges Anal, Be'efim Gilei Anashamesh, Anashamesh Rak Sheletes HaGuf. Beis HaGuf, Inim Metzius La'atz Miklal. Chalun Ishkin Zach Verzich. So in Behesim Le'beis Yifani Aveda, Kom Asech Yil Lashem Shemayim, B'chol Derech Echad Eim. It always says, it's not too, not saying the same Indian in two separate Indian. That first of all, it's masecha. What does it mean? It's masecha. Why does a person eat? Why does a person drink? Because that's his personal need. It's not the Eibishter. He's not doing it because the Eibishter gave him. He feels a need. He gets hungry. He feels a need to go eat. So he's eating. The need to eat, and the motivation to eat that comes from himself. A mensch wird hungrig. He has a guf. His guf becomes hungry. He wants to eat. So it's masecha. But shaila is, what is he going to use this meisim for? He's going to use it l'shem shemaim. Yeah, so that's in a bittul. L'shem shemaim. Aval ha-meisim asim yon ha-nechol. But what's eating? Eating is, the guf can't function without eating. So you're doing something to sustain your body. For what purpose do you have your body? Now, what is your body? Your body is a body. And your body has needs, and that's what you're eating is a physical need. It's not a get lechazach. It's not a duch nizegazach. It's a the body has a need to eat, and that's why you're eating. But what are you using your body for? Your body is going to be used to fulfill what Eibishter wants. That's one eifin. Aval aved b'chol derech de'eyu is eifin kaze shebchinas de'eyu, which is idea savayu who b'chol drache v'inyanam atzim. B'chol derech de'eyu is that in drachecha in ze'alin v'istalukus. You're meskasha to the Eibishter through drachecha them, through drachecha yourself, through drachecha.
He
leishem b'shvil deyu el shabehem ba'yadam atzmo yidei esavai. that in the Maisa, in the Chefts, in the Inyanaya Guf Gufe, Medamalay forbidden Zachvat Nebishn. Is Drachecha, he gets hungry, Taken. So the fact, eating is always from the Seirach HaGuf. But through his Guf Gufe, forbidden Zachvat Nebishn. Not through something else. That was going to teach you what it means. והפירוש בזה אף שלוחרם מקום למה שהדרך היחידי לא ולדרק יש דעי הוא הידי עניין הקדושה למצוא של הגיש ברוך וקיים מצווה סבל איך הגיע לזה ביסעסק בעניין הרשוס כמה בחולי משקה ומסוי מתוני אז תחזיין לזה זה עניין הרשוס הרס ונצרינק that's human needs nothing to do with all the cost תהיה למצוא דעי בשביל שתהיה למה שאין כן that's human needs eating, drinking, מסוי מתוני זה לא עניין הקדושה וכן זה פרבין ואת נאי בשביל דרך זה זה בו העירו ועד גושה צריך להיות גם בכל דרכי חוד אבל זין דעי Hainu, Sarachli is Shachila Atzmati Yigdeishu Mitzvah. The Rebbe is saying over here a whole different thing. Here, dealing with a case where a Yid, everything inside a Yid, the fact that he gets hungry, that doesn't give him any, it would just be Mitzvah such a Mitzvah. The same way that Rebbe is Medamet Al Derech Tachila Shabbos. So Achila Shabbos, the true way Achila Shabbos is, I'm not eating because I'm hungry. I'm not eating because I want to eat. This is a Mitzvah to eat. Like I eat Matzah. So I'm eating, it's not like, that's not a regular, eating lunch, you're eating lunch because you got hungry. So because I got hungry, I'm eating lunch. So the tzeirech to eat lunch that came from your guf. And so it's the achila, it's a regular, it's a achila shalashus. Meshekin read achila smatza, for example. You're eating matza, you're not eating because you're hungry. The evishot gehesen, esen matza. So since the evishot gehesen, esach matza. So then with this meister guf, I'm connecting to the evishot. I'm doing this while the evishot gehesen, not because the interest didn't come from me. So there's a yid that his whole kol drachecha is all the shame mili ratzon elyon. Nothing is nevea mitzad its mitzias. His guf has no tzrachim, has no ratzonis. His guf is just a mitzias, it's just a vehicle to malish ratzon elyon. Lepel, his guf gets hungry, but his whole guf, his whole, the fact that he gets hungry is all a levush telukus. It's all a tzerech telukus. Ayidah sat azah hergish. Ayidah has a hergish that be'etzem, why did the Eibusher make a need to go work? Is because be'etzem there's a mitzvah of tzedakah. And in order to have tzedakah, you have to work. B'meila, and in order for a person to go to work, he has to have an echveis, a cheshik to work. Therefore, that's why his guf has a cheshik to work. So either has that anachah, so when he goes to work, he's not going to work. He's going to do b'mekai mitzvah tzedakah. It's same anyone understands, if you're going to the store to buy tzitzis, so you're not going to do your matters, your inyan. You don't have a need to wear tzitzis. Deibishet geisen, ibadet geisen, you're going into the store. So going into the store, that's not called l'shem shamayim. It's not masechel l'shem shemayim. Lechatchila, that's a hechsher of a mitzvah. So that you're doing a maisa achana to kiyum ratzon elyon. That's what you're doing. Mashiach, when you're eating, even if you're eating l'shem shemayim, you're not doing a maisa achana to ratzon elyon, because the tzeirech that you had to eat was because you got hungry, and because you can't handle it, you can't function without food. But what are you going to use your food? What are you going to use your guf? Are you going to use it for the yebishter? But the tzeirech was neveim inside your guf. The second eifin is that your guf has no tzrachim. Your guf is not a mitzias. The only factor, the only mahus is the nefesh. He has needs, and what's the need? The need is chilek mamamish, bittel teratzin elyon. If Eibishter wants that I should go that I'm in zolegin tefillin in order to put on tefillin, I have to use a hand and I have to go to the store. That's called b'chol drachecha de'eyu. With drachecha guf I'm mekayim ratzin elyon. With drachecha guf I'm connecting to the Eibishter. So the tzir the Rebbe is mitzayir, the tzir in aveda, Ayid was halder by that his guf is only a tuffle to the ratzon elyon. So it's not shaykh to say that he should eat because his guf wants to eat. The guf has no wants. The guf is just a vehicle. It's just a daim. Kol tachlisi is lamalis ratzon elyon. So it says revert tungurik. The teretz. So what's that? The pshat. The pshat is there's a mitzvah. Let's say to give zakah. It's a mitzvah enek Shabbos. Because it's a mitzvah enek Shabbos, that's why the Eibusher made a teva kaviyachol that a guf is misanig me from gashmis. Let's say azam is third word. The whole mitzvah of guf is just l'shem b'chdeya the Eibusher's rasmus on the smaller burn. So why does the Rebbe in the order of Yitzchak zar adagan chilekein look at the sichus? The word Yitzchak felt that be'etzem he has no need for panos. But there's a mitzvah to give ma'aseh, a mitzvah to give tzedakah. In order to give tzedakah, he has to have nechasim. So that's the way a yid feels b'yachas to his going to work. He's going to work, but it's not a mitzvah. It's not ratzon elyon. It's going to work, but it's a achana. It's alei chetinsel lekayim ratzon elyon. That's the. So it says al derech hanshtarli shachila atzmet yekdeisha u'mitzvah. He's being memale his regular person eats. Even I at the benin is out today. The Rebbe saying, "I eat est lemale the raiv and a guf is hungry." What does he use his guf for? He uses guf for the Eibishter. But the act of eating is an act of taking away the thirst of the body. That's what the act of eating is. Here, the act of eating is not taking away thirst or hunger of the body. The act of eating is l'shem hechsher mitzvah. A mensch est as l'shem hechshem mitzvah. Not l'shem taking away the thirst and the hunger of the body. Because the body l'chatchil is not a mitzvah of nasme. V'haylir ak shebekeicha yilma dispa l'charkach. V'alderach achil l'shabes edas mitzvah achil l'skotch m'keitz v'zeh shem atzvah mitzvah. Bring this, or a yid l'moshel, his only reason why he's eating is, only he has no interest to eat. Est nor, only because he wants to learn. Yeah, that's the Adarach that Rebbe is saying over here. You have a yid that he doesn't have any tzedek to eat. The only reason why he's eating is because the teva guf is that he can't function without eating, and he wants to learn. But mainly, eats that eating is not that's bechoter chechadeyu. Then with that eating itself, it's a hechsher to go learn. The same way going to get a sefer is not a ma'aser rishus. That's a achana to go sit down and learn and take the gemara. Adarach is if someone's only eating just in order for him to have energy to learn. He has no interest klal in eating. So then, his whole eating is just the hechsher mitzvah to be able to have keiach to learn. That's the bechoter chechadeyu. So that's the pchina and aveda. If your guf is a mitzias for itself, it has a ratzin v'cheshik b'fnei atzmi. Elamai, it's bottled, it's nichnat in the neshama. Or l'chatchila, the whole mitzias a guf is a chetimtze that the neshama is kind of durch for in zayin azach. But it's not. It doesn't have a mohus for itself. That's the second life. It's still not chesedis, but not chesedis chabad. Because then it's not. Yeah, it's nisht. We'll see in a minute. These two sick aveda are tali vifol the nesham is mir and guf. That's the Rebbe's. Kshedag is galusa b'adam. Who even the shlita ala guf? That means vi herzach der emes. So herzach nish der emes with the emes is not fully bezgalus, because let's say the emes of the nesham, there is nothing else besides the Eibishter. He's magish the emes of alakus that alakus is insof. In the Eishter dag is nish mir the ganze emes. In what's far even is mere the remes that the Eibishter is he's the truth, he's the greatest. So as I'm asserted a hair which is not shaylo that there could be a guf, but etach not stam. We know the truth. The Rebbe saying with Zgali is that what's nirgash in the guf? What does he sense? You can only sense something that you're a keli to. That's massive to you. If you're not a keli to the hair, the hulav adi uvein zolase, then it's not nirgash in you. When there's a metzias of a guf, what could be nirgash in the guf? Mitzad gidre haragel, the way we know the guf, not atom kriim ad mashem adam, the way we know the guf. Es kenzer chenas frana emes. Not that there's nothing besides the emes. That there is an emes, and there's ilum haza, and there's an emes. And a melech which has mehertas da emes, you're nizbata, you're nichna. That's the first level. So that it's mezgale be'efin vifal the guf as a keli. It's not mezgale with its full glory. The emes herzach nish betachlis. So Kishtag is galus about the shlita ala guf, but a guf bleibt a metzias for zich, then it's a vedas b'chon Hashem Shemayim. Divrei Rishus in yana guf teisim esli mokim, metzias la'atzim. So the guf, and the guf has needs, and you care about those needs. You get hungry, and you get very annoyed if you don't eat. It bothers you. But you don't live your life for that. It's tuffel, your purpose of life is not to eat. The poil, you have a tzerech to eat, but that's not your purpose of life. So that's called the guf is nichnat ter nesham. It's used for the nesham. And yana guf teisim esli makim ki metzias la'atzim, so metzias farzich, azach farzich, elo she guf achol inyana kfuyim v'nechnoim l'nesham ha'shalat esalav. B'meile, in yisus b'el shem davar kim l'shem shemayim. Aval k'shan nesham b'gili kolkach, that means the nesham, the emes of the nesham is meir b'izgalus, with the full glory. So herzach der emes b'izgalus. Because herzach der emes b'izgalus, what's the emes? As nishta esu the meibishn. So because der emes is meir b'izgalus, what's treftzach yamud? Ad she aguf mizbatel legamer mi yis. What is home mitzias? Bechdei ader ebeshes kavana zol zech yisrin. As gamma vidas ebin yana gufa oilam chines deyu. Ma'achash im mitzias nirgash fin asmen klav ar yudeas hakish baruch behem vayod. The mitzias of guf is not nirgash. The only thing what's nirgash is that there yechetimtsa sedurk from a derebish tervo. But that's still not the ultimate thing. We should go weiter. I don't know. Sometimes after an hour people get tired. We'll go a little bit. There was like this. There is a Sof Kol Sof. This is still not what Chassidus is. At least the Tzavah of the Magid Chassidus Chabad. This is not Chassidus. There was like this. At the end of the day, the way we're saying, just say one part. The way we're saying before is there's a goof. There's Gashmis. And there is a Nefesh. The Nefesh, there's the truth. There's the truth and there's Elam Hazah. The truth is the Neshama is kosher to them. And there's goof. Elam Hazah is Yesh, Mitzis. So there's two eifanim, how strong the nevesh could impact the guf. How much could the nevesh be made in the guf? One eifan is that the guf bleibt amitzius, he's nichnat in the nesham. And one eifan is that the guf verta tofel to the nesham, he becomes a chetimtzit to mila nesham. But at the end of the day, but the Rebbe is saying the Nekudah Chassidus is going to be not that there's a goof which is going to be impacted by the Nesham, which is going to sense the Nesham. The Uftah Chassidus is that Sidon Nar in Nekudah, the Nekudah is on Nesham itself. There's no two Nekudahs. There's no goof which is being impacted by the Nefesh. There's only the Nekudah of the Nesham itself, purely. Either there's a goof, the goof doesn't take away anything from the purity of the Nesham. Since even in the second Eifel that we're speaking about before, the Nesham is Betachlis Hagili. But it's the tachlis vifal the neshama can meir zayin by a guf, not the way the neshama senses itself in itself. In the second eifin, it's there says it's a mitis. There was lashon before, a mitis in a gila neshama beguf. That means we're dealing with the ultimate of how much the neshama could be meir in the guf, not the ultimate of what the neshama is in respect to the neshama itself. That's there's a guf. How much could the guf handle? There's the guf could handle the eini begila kolkach. It's a begila mukbal. The guf blived him and says, or tachas hagili is that the guf is mizbatel legamri to the nefesh. But that's all vifal, that's at the end of the day, not the way the nefesh senses itself, the emes. That's the way the emes is nirgesh in the guf. Then there is a sifran nerd the nekudas hanesham alin. And the fact that there's a guf doesn't take away at all from the inyan itself. Because there's only one inyan, there's only nesham. There's no nesham impacting and functioning through a guf, bechlal. You heard where the Rebbe's going to go.
It's a diner.
No, what I'm saying, like we were saying before the Gabi the Shluchas, they were saying that it's Tachlis Aruchnis. There's no Tifis Asmakim Klal Tametzias of Zulas. In the second Eifin is the Neshama being, there's the Neshama itself, he's a Chelik Amim Ma'amamish, and there's the fact that the Neshama is Begili Beguf. He's Meir Begili Beguf. But even though he's Meir Begili Beguf, and the Guf is response to the ultimate Gili of the Neshama, but it's not the Inyan the way it is in the world of the Neshama itself. It's not Tachlis Aruchnis. Is the neshama being nirgash in the guf? We'll see what's the pchina. I'm just saying what's the idea. There I was going to say a pchina of how it, where the inyan, where it expresses itself. But the inyan is lepedesh tumetziyasin. There's an emes and there's a guf, and the shal is how much the guf is going to be impacted by this emes. How much is going to be affected by this emes?
So he's not eating.
No, he's going to eat. We're not dealing with. There's no technical stuff. This technically he eats and he drinks. The shal is what's your attitude towards eating and drinking? We're going to see in a minute the attitude, which was the Indian itself. The attitude we're going to see in a minute. Yeah, it does happen to the hair and the attitude to the Indian. There's what does it. We'll see first what the Rebbe says here. So, Aleph, yeah, the Rebbe said before, why is he eating? He's only eating because he has to learn. He doesn't have, not because he's hungry, not because he gets exhausted and he has to eat, he gets tired, not because of that. He wants to learn. He only cares about learning. In order to learn, he needs to have energy. Ravet gedar fashtein the gemara to gedar esen flesh. Chamer v'reicha marche v'sadas. So why? Not because he enjoyed flesh. He had no interest in flesh. Why was he eating? Because it's marche to be able to learn. That eating, that's not masechel l'shem shemayim. That's b'chod ochecha de'eyu. That was just a hakdama to learning. That's a chetimsa to learning. That's a chana to do ratznali. That's not considered b'chom masechel. But because then nirgash basiyos and gamagasha shiben, but it's nirgash eiser from the Indian of kiyum ratzon ha'eli and eiser the Indian of achanat avedas Hashem. It's nirgash also the gashmish of it. There brings a dugma. Derech mashal achilas Shabbos she atzam mitzvah kanal. Yeah, lepel it's a mitzvah. So a person's not eating because he's hungry. A person's eating cholent because there's a mitzvah to enjoy Shabbos. He has no interest in enjoying. Yeah, but that tzaddik. He's not interested in enjoying himself. That's not his Indian. Favas Esther. Adayim shet gehesin esin Esther. Mikol mekem. But what's the mitzvah? He only cares about the only factor in his life is that it's a mitzvah. But what's the mitzvah? A mitzvah atzem chayevus la'anik shabbos b'boser shomim v'yayin yoshem. Hashigam be'ez kiyum a mitzvah murgeshes gashmi yusam. Shebo u'atanish advarim elu. I just want to bring out one thing, the tzir that Rebbe is being mitzayer, and then Rebbe is saying like this. Let's say there's a mitzvah of inik shabbos. L'poel, you sense the flesh tastes good. And he senses it. Who's this nekudah that the baser shaman has a good taste? That's a gashmiz gezach or that's a getlech gezach? See, why he's eating? That's because of the mitzvah. If not for the mitzvah, you would never go to eat. But what is the mitzvah? But lepel, what is the mitzvah that he should enjoy this shtickle flesh? Lepel, that hana is a gashmiz dekana. So he's sensing the gashmiz dek side of the food. You're not sensing the gashmiz. You're not sensing ruchnis. You're not sensing a mitzvah. You're sensing gashmiz.
But his world isn't that alikos?
What do you mean isn't that alikos? Why is it alikos? I'm sorry, I just want to first the chilek that I was saying. I was saying is one eifin, the second thing that I'm speaking about is that the chelik hagash medin is b'chal na'nirgash. The only thing that you're sensitive to is a mitzvah. Here, lepel, there's ruchnis and there's gashmis. And gashmis is a separate mitzvah. Ruchnis has no taste, there's no geshmak. Gashmis is geshmak. Lepel, mitzvah the mitzvah, you sense gashmis. But you're sensing gashmis, lepel. You're sensing a mitzvah is gashmis. The second eifin is, you don't sense gashmis altogether. Because the whole mitzvah of gashmis by you is a yichetim tzitelukos. That's your whole mitzvah of gashmis.
Don't
sense
you don't
mekayim
taka
in achilu
shabbos.
You don't mekayim.
You don't have a
nor
from the.
It's not hashal. These
are the
gmois. The any shabbos is the gmois.
The hanor is part of the mitzvah.
One second, we'll get to that. How to be miyashiv the mitzvah? What's the Rebbe saying over here? The Rebbe saying over here is even. There's one if the first definition is that kol asiyosef taka is kedusha, but it's nirgash also the gashmius of the chayfitz. You're asking what's the issue that it feels the gashmius? Good, but the Rebbe saying that's a problem. He feels also the chilek gashmi of the chayfitz. That means that the basar hatatam, a gashmi is the getam. Feels good. Yeah? Tastes good in the mouth. A gashmi is the getam. And he's margish that. He feels the taste, the gashmi is the side of the food he tastes. He doesn't only taste mitzvahs. He doesn't only sense mitzvahs. He senses gashmis. He senses guf. He senses gashmis. The hechad eifin is he doesn't sense gashmis at all. He doesn't sense gashmis. He only senses ruchnis, mitzvahs, and ratzon elyon. Not gashmis and things. Doesn't sense gashmis and things. You're asking, what's the mile of it? We'll get to that in a minute. The Rebbe's Metzayer first, the guf in it. The Rebbe brings later the story of the Alter Rebbe. That Alter Rebbe didn't sense if the food was salty or not. Et nisht margish given. Because what was the whole mitzvah of gashmis? The whole mitzvah of gashmis was ratzon elyon. That was the whole mitzvah of gashmis. There was only one inyan. The inyan is, there's no two inyanim. There's no gashmis and a lukus. And gashmis is a tuffel to lukus. There's no, the only inyan that exists is a lukus. What is gashmis? An eifin the way a lukus is. Nothing else. Gashmis is not a mitzvah for itself. It's not a reality for itself. There's no reality of gashmis. And this reality is a tuffel to a lukus. The reality is the Eibishter. That's the only reality that exists. Avada, there is physical things, but they're not. That's not the physical thing. Is just is a tzir har ratzon elyon is. That's the gashmis. We'll see in a minute the gemara. The what's the reality of gashmis? It's an eifin how a lukus is. The way the first eifin is there's a lukus. There's elam hazeh. Elam hazeh is a tuffel of but is a levush to lukus. But what is the levush? The levush is gashmis. The levush is elam hazeh. What's elam hazeh? Not a mohus b'fnei atzmi. The mohus of elam hazeh is a tuffel to lukus. So the pearl, but gashmis is a mitzvah. And if the mitzvah is, if the ratzon elyon is to sense the gashmis, to enjoy the gashmis, so you're going to enjoy the gashmis, mitzvah the mitzvah. But gashmis is gashmis. Gashmis is not a lukus. Gashmis is ilam hazer. The second eifin, so the pearl, there's two mitzvahs. The second eifin is there's only one reality. The only reality is a lukus. What's gashmis? Gashmis is another form how a lukus is. I'm not saying it right, but that's the eifin calling the word. What's gashmis? Gashmis is a chetimtze via lukus kumtan. There's an eifin that a lukus kumtan in ruchnis. There's an eifin that a lukus kumtan kaviyachal in physical terms. But inin is not physical. The inin is a lukus kumtan, not the physical. The Rebbe brings this here. But the mashal, the sicha, when the Rebbe says yitzkis lechafei, the Rebbe brings the mashal of ameitzah eichel pachas mikashir. The guy with the second inin, ameitzah eichel pachas mikashir. So he's potter afalakli. Even if he's mitzi, he wants to be mitzi food on Shabbos, but the food has less than the shir hamayil inyan lacha Shabbos. Even though the kli has a shir, but he took out the tiny bit of soup in a massive pot. He's potter. Why? Because he had no interest in being mitzi the pot. He wanted to be mitzi soup. The pail, the way you carry soup is through a pot. But he wasn't carrying the pot. He's carrying soup. The pot is not. So if your whole reason why you carry, not because you're interested in being mitzi the pot, you want to carry soup. The way to carry soup is through a pot, then it makes a difference to you what type of pot you have, this type of pot or that type of pot. That's not relevant, b'chol. The pot is just a chetimtze for the soup. Then what type of pot doesn't make a difference. You're not carrying a pot to begin with. You're carrying soup. You're not carrying a pot. You're holding a pot. The avadi technically you're holding a pot. That's just a way to carry soup. You're not carrying the pot. There's no chalais that I'm carrying a pot over here. That's not the definition of the act. The definition is that I'm carrying soup. I'm carrying soup through a pot. So al-dera said the shayla is, in the first eifin, it's not just that you're carrying soup. You're eating. You're dealing with elam hazeh, mitzad the mitzvah. Because of the mitzvah, mitzad the mitzvah, you're dealing with elam hazeh. Not mitzad the mitzvah. You have no shayla. Your whole inyan is kiyum ratzon elyon. But elam hazeh is a mitzvah. Elam hazeh is a mitzvah. It's a mitzvah for itself. A pot is a reality. There's a mitzvah of a pot. The whole mitzvah is a tofel, a levush They're not Ratzon Elyon. The pot is not Ratzon Elyon. He's a levush b'chdei de'ebush is Ratzon Shebina Smala. But he's a metzias. So if the Ratzon is to eat matzah and to taste the taste of food, you're going to taste the physical taste of food. The mitzvah of Enishamah is a dogma. Everyone wants to bring out the idea that the fact that that the whole metzias is a mitzvah doesn't mean that the metzias is not a metzias. The fact that your b'shvil, your whole inyan is a tafel, a levush ton inyan, doesn't mean that the levush doesn't have gedarim. The levush has a metzias, the levush has a tam, the levush has a geshmak. And fakert, amol de malubish wants you to get involved in the levush. It's tak a levush. And only mitzad de malubish you're going to get involved in the levush. But the levush is a metzias. In the second eifin, there is no levush. There's only the nekuda of elukus. There's nothing, no other nekuda. What's gashmis is a form, another form of how elukus is. There was a tzair over there, he brings say this, Kabbalah Samach Shemaim. You say Kabbalah Samach Shemaim, Miken, Kabbalah Samach Shemaim, the Indian of that a Yid's Mekabbalah Samach Shemaim has to be expressed on all levels of reality. So how is it expressed on a Ruchnistic level? As a Tracht, Mekabbalah of Zichel Samach Shemaim. How is it expressed verbally? Verbally it's expressed, Amezok Krishma. So when he's verbally saying Krishma, he's not sensitive to the fact that he's saying words. There's no reality of words. The reality is that Kabbalah Samach Shemaim is on all levels. It's not that there's a world of words and the Eibusher says, I want you to do the world of words. There is no world of words. There's Kabbalah Samach Shemaim. But Kabbalah Samach Shemaim has to be expressed on all levels. It has no limits. It has to be expressed on all levels. So how is it the Pelamish expressed so it has to be expressed also on a verbal level. But then he's not sensitive to the words. He's sensitive only to the Kabbalah Samach Shemaim of the words, not to the words, not to the world of words. Because there's no metzias of worlds. There's no reality like that. So shtaz metzias. In the first name, it's a dam metzias from a guf. The question is, how much is it? Is it a metzias for itself, or it's a levush to the neshama? But there's such a reality. There's a reality of words. The question is, are they only an emtzai for an inyan, or they're an ikar? But even if they're an emtzai, lepel, there's a metzias. It's a reality of words, which are a tafel to something else. The even that I'm saying over here is there is no reality of words. L'chatchilus, neshama is a metzias. The eitz gezach b'sefaran is the nekuda v'elukus, and the nekuda v'elukus is mizbat in all eifanim. But if Fanim are not a Metzias, it's the Nekudah V'Lukus itself. Nekudah V'Lukus on all levels. So you see the Mitzvah Enek Shabbos. The Mitzvah Enek Shabbos is that you're, let's say, but you have to have Anah from a Lukus. You have to have Anah from Ruchnis, from a Lukus. So it's Mizvata that on all levels, Shabbos has to be, Kedush has to be a Dovra Nene. So where is the Hanah, Mizvata, Nagash, Mizdika way that you feel physical pleasure? But the Nekudah, it's not the Nekudah, the Nekudah, the pleasure is not from the Gashmis. It's that Elukus, the fact that Elukus is a Dover Toiv, has to be Mizbata on all levels. That's a different Indian.
But then you would feel it.
Say, but I'm not, that brings a Dugma, that's not the Nekudah. But you feel it, it's a different Nekudah. L'chatchila, the Shaz, what Gashmis is. The Rebbe is being mitzayir. The Dugma is not, the Rebbe is not trying to say that you're not supposed to have any Shabbos. The Rebbe is being a Dugma for the Indian that Gashmis is a Metzias. And even but Gashmis is Mitzias, but how could and you could be sent even Mitzad Avayda of Chodr Chachadei or the first and the second Eifin, the first Eifin, I'm saying the second Eifin or before the first Eifin. Now you could be Margish the Gashmis, and it could be Megashmi, because the Mitzvah Guf is Mechayev you to sense the Gashmis. And I'm saying the Etzem fact Teira and Mitzvahs is not going to take care of the word that Elam Hazah is not a separate Mitzias. Ayid Vaslikta Shalom Vazav Nomachsidus. Mitzatayru mitzvahs itself. Mitzatayru mitzvahs itself. Ayid's whole chayis is going to be, you know, Ayid that's fully aware of the fact that the Anabish that he created the world, and the world is created, the Shamash is kind, he's going to learn the Gemara and Kiddushin, and he's going to be, his whole mitzvah is going to be Durfin Ratzanel. What's that wrong with Sukhsidis? But the Rebbe says, but what's Gashmis? What is Gashmis? Gashmis is Chaymer, Gashmis is not Holocaust. And if I cared, I'm on Chsidis, Lepoil, Tzfaran Zelcha mitzvahs, that the Choram are demand you Gashmis. They demand. Even if you're a chassidish, calling yoni is ratzon elyon. Ratzon elyon guf tells you to do. There's mitzvah ma'asis. So a regular mitzvah ma'asis of putting on tefillah, of chveis, shaking the lulav, it's not going to make any akshame because a ma'asis mitzvah. But azalcha mitzvah v'ayinik Shabbos. So what hanoah? That's going to be hanoah ruchnis. That's hanoah from flesh. So now your gashmis is going to be neschazik l'pah. Your guf now felt better. There's a reality of guf. It exists and it felt and it expanded now. Your guf expanded. Mashiach in the second event that I was going to speak, there is no two tenuas b'chol.
So you think the doom of Shabbos is for the first event?
The Shabbos is a dogma. The Rebbe is not...
First. No, it's not Achid Shabbos. The Kli.
For the second event. No, the Kli is more. The Kli is... He's not Maitzi a pot. He's carrying soup. He's not carrying a pot. The Avada, technically, there's a pot there. He's not... His Pu'ula is not Mesiachis, there's a pot. So technically, he's saying words. The words are not the Indian. He's saying Kabbalah Samach Shamayim. That's what he's saying. How is Kabbalah Samach Shamayim expressed? Ba'avir Olam, through words. The Indian is not words. He's not carrying a pot. There's no mitzvah. There's no reality of a pot, Kavyal. There's only a reality of soup. Technically, there's Yashalis. Is there a reality of Gashmis? Is there something called? Is there a Eifel Mitzvah of Gashmis? Other Shishla is Eifel Mitzvah. There's only Elukus. Elukus is in different Eifanim. So the Eifanim aren't a Mitzvah of Nasim. They're Eifanim of how Elukus expresses itself. It's not a Mitzvah for itself. That's a pot is a way you carry soup. It's not a Mitzvah of carrying a pot. Meherit Amin, Samaritan Amin.
The lower level of Bechol Rechacha shouldn't be called
Hashem Shemayim. No, it's not. Bechol Matzal Hashem Shemayim means that Elam, that your Mitzvah, the Guf is a Mitzvah for itself. It's a Mahus for itself. Not just, it's not a reality.
It's Hashem
Shemayim. I'm saying not that the Guf is a Mahus for itself. There's a Mitzvah. There's a property of Gashmis and there's a property of Ruchnis. Ruchnis is the purpose, is the Matar. It's the purpose of everything. It doesn't mean it's the only reality that exists. It's the purpose. But there's another reality. It's the reality of Guf. How could they say otherwise? There's no reality of Guf. There's no food. There's no. It's in the second world. It's the Sada world. What was the world created for? What's its purpose is Elokus? Over Sada world? What are you going to say? There's no world. And sometimes the purpose is Mechayev you to deal with the world. So then you're going to be Mizgashim. If by you, in Sodom Mitzvahs, which have to do with Gashmis. If by you Gashmis is a Mitzvah, it's not the purpose. It's not like the first day where Gashmis is a world for itself. Gashmis is a reality for itself. You're Machniyeh et Elokus. Here, by you, Gashmis is a Tafel. But it's a Tafel, but it doesn't mean that Tafel doesn't exist. The Tafel exists. Gashmis exists as a Tafel to Elokus. Since Gashmis exists, if the Iker is Mechayev you, the Mitzvah says, enjoy Gashmis. So the Gashmi is the pearl is going to be Gashmi you. It's going to make it's going to expand your nefesh
b'amis. So you're doing this l'shem shemayim, so it should be counted.
You're doing it as a mitzvah. Ayid es the Rebbe's tzir of enek Shabbos is he's eating not because he enjoys chant. L'shem shemayim is not, you're doing it because you want to do it, because you have a need to do it. It's your need. You're doing it for the purpose of l'shem shemayim. Chotar is something else. I don't want to do this. Chvul s'shtan. I only want to do what the Eibushter wants. I don't want to get involved in Gashmi. I don't want to get involved in it. Why am I getting involved? The Eibushter make hasten. That's why I'm getting involved. That's Bechol Derechecha. I'm doing this. I'm being Miskasha to the Eibushter now. I'm being Mekayim Ratzon Elyon. That's what I'm doing. But with what are you doing? What does Ratzon Elyon say? How are you fulfilling Ratzon Elyon? Through Gashmis to get things. Gashmis is not Ratzon Elyon. Gashmis is Gashmis, not Ratzon Elyon. Ratzon Elyon is the Eibushter's Ratzon. And then there's, what does he want me to do? To do Gashmis. So the Pearl, Gashmis is not Ratzon Elyon. So the Gashmis will be Mekashmi. My goof is not the Neshama. My goof is a goof. My Neshama is the Mahus of the goof. It's the main purpose of the goof. But there is a reality of guf, and there's a teva guf, there's a mitzias of guf, and that teva guf is that it's margish a tam v'tainig in gashmis. But al terebe there's no teva of guf. There's no guf. There's only elikus, stuck in guf. Either there's a guf. The guf is a chetimtze and that elikus mizbata bekol eifan. That was going to give later a dogma. The whole the guf is really an inin ruchnis, not an inin gashmi. It's gashmis. But it's the Indian is not Gashmis. The Indian is that the Ruchni should be expressed on all levels. That's what Rebbe's going to explain by Amshah. Okay, maybe we'll do this next time. We'll do this with Yashvas. Let us learn. Let's know what Amshah is in the Indian.
It's the same few diaries as Kolob Shalom?
No. This is not. The Rebbe is saying not. The Rebbe is Shailo Gashmis over here. The Rebbe is saying Gashmis is not a Mitzis. Kolob Shalom, the Rebbe is saying you have to mevatel anything. The Gashmis, K'meshuhum Mamish, is an expression of the truth. The Rebbe is saying that the Gashmis is not Nirgash over here. The Gashmis is Batl. There's only Nefesh. There's only Ruchnis. That's the Rebbe saying here. There's only Ruchnis. Either there's a physical reality. There's no reality of Gashmis. Technically, Kabbalah Samach Shamayim, how is it Mizbata practically that a Yid it puts on tefillin? But the act of putting on tefillin is the Indian of Kabbalah Samach Shamayim being expressed on a practical level. But practical level itself, Stam Gashmis itself, doesn't exist, B'chlal, as the Rebbe is saying. His shaylah a mitzias outside of the inyan. There's an inyan. There's an inyan of elikus. There's an inyan of ratzon elyon. There's an inyan of kabbalas marshamayim. And that inyan exists on all levels and expresses itself on all levels. So anything outside of that inyan doesn't exist. Because Hashem is saying more than that. That the gashmis k'meishu hum mamish is an expression of the truth. That's a different word. Okay, but we'll see the mitzvah of pratum and b'slosh b'tah. You're going to have to understand why Shlichus is Mechayiv Dafke by Yaakov. Gave Stone Magers and the Minion to. No, okay.
Why? Why should
Magish
the Tam?
Okay, that's not a shayla.
That's the whole thing.
The Rebbe will bring in a dugma. Now you're saying, but you have no kasha on this Sibra. That must bring a dugma. Well, the Sibra later, we'll see later. Go to
them. Huh?
Right, because what's Gashmir? It's Gashmir. It's Gashmir. It's Gashmir. It's Gashmir.
So it's not
ruggish to the words.
He's not, but he says words.
That's all a bit of course.
So the Zal's alt is a bit of everything. But he feels doesn't feel tam. He doesn't say the word. It's like saying if he doesn't feel the.
But I'm saying in the Tumah that brings her tam is a bit that there's a metzias of gashmis.
Vert is also a bit to you. That is a gashmis. And you're saying, give us a vert, you're saying, Shema Yisrael, Shem Elokeinu, Hashem Echad.
I'm not here.
Go through the next time.
Okay, isn't that the whole word of the second? That you don't feel that.
You don't feel the gashmis. The gashmis is an inyan ruchni. The gashmis is the inyan being misbata on a practical level.
So
the metzias physical itself doesn't exist. So nishta zazach was heard angry from gashmis. So ruchni was kumt on a natsir from gashmis. So nishta zazach. Nishta zazach a gashmis. Nishta zazach.
So why he couldn't have felt.
You're going into the Altareba case, that's a different discussion. We're not going
that's
in.
The Dubu for the second beer, no?
No, it's not the Dubu. The Rebbe, we'll see.
Okay.
Well, it is, but we'll see the. There's a shtickle, darkest dick of their hair, which you need to. We'll see it.